Hey guys, it's me Sylvia, back with another video. Here I am, back at it again for you guys. And today I'm gonna be showing you guys how I do my own lash extensions at home by myself for a very, very cheap, reasonable price. Now hold up, okay? I need to take this time in the video to tell you guys that this is not a certified method. Like, I am not a certified lash extension expert person. You know, this is just what I do on myself. And you know, if you completely disagree on people doing their lash extensions themselves at home, and you really don't think it's a good idea for people to do this on their own at home, I completely respect that. I did it both ways. I went to a professional the first time, and then I started to refill them on my own. So I understand both sides, but this video is just for the people who have been asking me how I do it. And for those people who, you know, see the products on the shelves or on Amazon and are really thinking about trying it on their own, I'm hoping that my tips and this video will help you before you do try it out on your own, because there is a lot that you should know and there's a lot that can go wrong when you're doing your lash extensions by yourself. As long as you know that and you do a lot of research on your own and you do practice caution when you're doing this on yourself, then I think you'll be okay. I mean, my eyes have not fallen out, so I think I'm okay. I have seen other YouTubers talk about how they do their lash extensions as well. Specifically, it's my Ray Ray. She's an amazing YouTuber. She did a video on this method as well, so I'm gonna leave her link down in the description. You guys should definitely go check her video. If you want kind of like a second opinion, a second tutorial on how to do this, then she'll definitely help you out as well. Now, before we start the video, don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed to my channel already. That way you're notified when I drop a new video every single Sunday and a bonus video throughout the week. And now that we got all that out of the way, let's get started with the tutorial. Now let's get into the nitty-gritty of it. So I'm gonna be using Ardell's individual lashes starter kit. So this actually comes with kind of like everything you need to do this. It comes with your lash glue and something to remove the lashes when you decide you no longer want them on your lashes. And it also comes with an assortment of lashes, short, medium, long. And then it also comes with a tweezer here to apply the falsies to your natural lash. I believe this goes for like $10 at the drugstore, so it's very, very affordable. Compared to getting your lashes done professionally, I believe it can range from like $80 to $150 for a new set. So there is a huge price difference. Some will argue that you're paying for it in quality, which is probably true. I mean, it's $10. It's not gonna be the best thing in the world. So just keep that in mind when deciding if you wanna do this professionally or do it at home. There is a difference in quality, obviously. And I also usually grab an extra pack of individual lashes just so that way I never run out, and I always have the different sizes to create the lash look that I want. You can see that these are not completely my natural lashes. I do have some lash extensions left over from the last time I did this. Most of them have fallen off naturally, but you can see there are still some left. So right now I'm just gonna refill them. If you are doing a new set of lashes, it's gonna take you a little bit longer. It's very, very tedious. You have to be patient. And obviously you're gonna have to place them a little bit differently than what I'm doing today, because right now I'm just gonna fill in the gaps of where I don't have any lash extensions. And you wanna make sure that your eyelashes are clean and dry before doing this, that there's no remnants of makeup on there. Usually I like to use a spoolie brush to brush them out and make sure that they are straight and in place and not looking crazy, and that all of the dust and everything is just brushed right out of them. So once you've cleaned off your eyelid and your eyelashes, you can go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna take the lash tight adhesive. So this is just the lash glue, and I'm just gonna pour that out on a piece of tin foil because it does dry up very, very quickly. So to preserve it in the bottle, I'm just gonna quickly tighten it up and just use what I have on the tinfoil. Now I'm ready to start putting on the lashes. I'm gonna go in with the medium length ones first just to create a base. And you can see that these are lash clusters. So there's more than one lash in a little single cluster. And this is actually not recommended because they can be very heavy and straining on your one natural lash, since you do have to adhere them to just one of your lashes at a time. So it takes a little bit more work, but you can decide to cut them in half if you want them to be a little bit lighter on each of your lashes. Up to you. I'm just gonna use the full cluster. So now it's ready to get the lash glue on there. I dip it into the glue probably between like two or three times to make sure it's got a good amount. And then you want to place it coming from a downward angle right on top of one of your natural lashes. You want to make sure you're not getting it on your eyelid. So you can see here, I left about like a millimeter or two between my eyelid and where I actually landed the false eyelash. And that's just because it makes it very, very uncomfortable if you're putting it on your eyelid. It's not going to come off as easily. It's going to be irritating, and you're not going to get your desired look of it being natural and comfortable because they won't be on your actual lashes. So make sure you're just always placing it on your own natural lash. And when you're doing it on yourself, a lot of people think it's hard, but what I do is I just push down on my natural lash with my nail, and then that way I can see a little bit better where I'm meant to place the false lash. Also, using a really magnified mirror will help you see better too. And after gluing a couple lashes, I'll always make sure to push them upwards. This is gonna make sure that they're not gonna look droopy and they're not gonna look like they're facing down. You want them all to be naturally like curled upwards. And usually after I place the individual lash down, I'll always adjust it with the tweezers to make sure it's facing the right way, it's not crooked, and it just falls in line with my natural lashes. So I usually will just put the medium lashes evenly all across my natural lash line to give me like an even base to work off of. So after placing like the medium length lash all over, I'll usually take a good hard look in the mirror and make sure that they're even, there's no gaps, and then that's when I can move on to the longer length lash. Now to avoid mistakes and gluing it on in the wrong spot, I'll sometimes place them on my lid without glue first to see how it looks, especially since the long length ones are a little bit dramatic. And if I like the placement, then I'll go back in with the glue to make it more permanent. And I like to take these long length ones and really focus them just on the most outer corner part of my lash line, and that's gonna give me more of like a cat eye look. But it's really up to you the way you like to customize your lashes. Maybe you want the long length ones in the middle, you know, up to you. You can really customize it however you like depending on the lash sizes. And you see me here just gently pushing down on the root of the false lashes to make sure they're nice and glued to the natural lash and they're not gonna be sliding around. I want them to stay exactly where I landed them. So after I think I have enough long length ones, I'll go in with some short ones. And these ones are the ones that I'm gonna place on the most inner corner part of my lashes. Now I'm always really careful here because this is the most sensitive part of your eye, and if you put too many or you mess up where you glue them, it can be very, very uncomfortable and it can feel like you're being poked in the eye pretty much. So I'm pretty sure I only put like 2 or 3 clusters in this spot, and they weren't attached to like the lashes that were way, way, way on the inner corner. I was very cautious of putting them too close to my tear duct so then they wouldn't be uncomfortable. So now I'm just taking a final look at the lash to make sure there's no gaps, it's exactly how I want it to look, and that everything is glued into place. And that's pretty much it. I have my one eye done. This is the final look. You can see it's a little bit longer on the outer corner, which is what I was going for, and I like the look. You can obviously go a lot more dramatic if you want, but this is how I like it. So, and when I look down, you can see a little bit of the glue there, but that does kind of subside, and you can get black glue if you don't want that little like shininess there, but I don't mind it. There's not a lot. And these shots are just so you can see the difference between the eye that I did on the left and the eye that still needs to be done on the right. It's a pretty dramatic difference, but you can obviously still see some of the leftover extensions on the eye that I still have to refill. But yeah, that's the one eye finished, and now I'm just gonna do the other eye off camera since you guys already know the process, and I'll get back to you when it's completely done. All done, alrighty. That's the power of editing. It actually took mad long in real life, but this is the finished look. I got both eyes done. I tried to make them as even as possible, and I really like the way they turned out. So that's the end of the video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you liked seeing, you know, the process that I go through to get these lash extensions on my eyes. And some final tips about eyelash extensions is that you are not meant to wet your eyelashes after you get the extensions on there for about 24 hours. You're meant to only use oil-free makeup remover, usually with a Q-tip. Otherwise, the oil will break down the glue and they'll come right off a lot faster. Also, another tip is to make sure that you're brushing your lashes out every morning or every night, just to make sure that they are staying straight and that they're not getting all tangled up, because that's sometimes can happen and then they'll look crazy. Also, if you're skeptical about trying this on yourself at all and you don't think you're capable, I highly recommend you go see an actual eyelash like expert that will do it for you, because they know what they're doing, you guys. So, you know, I just gotta say that, because if you go blind or something, I really don't want to be held responsible. Sorry, don't listen to me. Just don't do anything that I'm doing. So I think that's all for now. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Mwah. Peace. I'm just gonna try it on my face because, you know, I go hard. Oh, that sounds exactly like an exfoliator, actually.